Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for November the 28th of 2020, well, it is titled NGC 6822, Barnard's Galaxy. So what do we see here? Well, this is a galaxy, and while it may not look like any of the great spiral galaxies that we often look at, or even an elliptical galaxy, it is an example of a galaxy, and in this case, what we call an irregular galaxy. Irregular galaxies, as you might guess from their name, have no regular shape to them. So while an elliptical galaxy is a blob of stars and a spiral galaxy is a disk galaxy with a distinct spiral structure, irregular galaxies have no distinct pattern to them. And we can see here that there really is no pattern to that. We don't see any spiral arms, and it doesn't appear to be a very symmetrical galaxy either, like a great elliptical. Now, this is part of our local group of galaxies, a group of several dozen galaxies that happen to be close to the Milky Way. And it includes the Milky Way and the Andromeda Galaxy, in addition to a number of smaller galaxies. Now, one of the things that we see in it is that is reminiscent of spiral galaxies like our own Milky Way is we see evidence of star formation. So star formation does not just occur in larger spiral galaxies, but is currently going on in irregular galaxies too. So they do have some properties of spiral galaxies in that they have cold gas and dust within them that can form stars. And the evidence that we see for that here are the bluer stars. You can see the line of them towards the central region of this galaxy centered on the image. And those blue stars we know formed recently because they don't live for a very long time. And that means they must have formed recently. So for example, if something only lives for 10 or 20 million years, that's about as old as it can be. If it had formed more than that, such as 50 or 100 million years ago, those stars would be long since gone and we would not see them anymore. So just the fact that we see them in this galaxy means that they must have formed within the last few millions of years. We also see great stretches of nebulae as well. All the reddish glow that we see here is hydrogen gas, which glows when excited by ultraviolet radiation from hot stars. And those are also similar to those hot blue stars that I talked about earlier. So they must have formed recently because they don't live for a very long time. So when we see things like this, the blue stars and the red emission nebulae, those are signs of star formation. And we see those in our galaxy, as well as in Barnard's galaxy that we're looking at today. So that was our picture of the day for November the 28th of 2020. It was titled NGC 6822, Barnard's Galaxy. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be falling off a cliff. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.